So next we're going to hear from Helen about her experience as a first-time TA in an introductory physics course.
Hi, my name is Helen. I'm studying environmental engineering. Last semester, I took a class to build upon my educational skills. I was an undergraduate TA in a physics class.
As part of Helen's educational skill development course, she was asked to complete an interview project, and this involved finding someone who wasn't a STEM major and asking them an open-ended physics problem and then videotaping the interview. So now take a moment to look over the goals of the assignment, and this is excerpted from a handout that she received. So the focus was to practice asking questions to better understand their interviewee's ideas and to not lead in any way to some correct answer. So the course assignment was iterative. They developed a set of questions to ask. They performed and videotaped the interview. Then they reflected on it. They developed a new set of questions to ask, found a new person to interview, performed and videotaped the second interview, and then reflected on the whole experience. So I was able to talk to Helen via Skype at her home in Texas, and we'll get to hear a little bit about what she learned in this project, and she's also going to share with us some clips from her interview videos.
So our first clip is a short segment of an interview that I did with my roommate, and we discussed how when you turn on an electric stove, the coils become red.
So take a moment to look at Helen's interview question and how you might think about it so that you can interpret what her interviewees are saying. So I'll give you just a moment to do that. As you watch this first video, think about these three questions. So the first one is, what about the interview just kind of catches your attention? The second one is, to what extent do you think Helen successfully elicits ideas? And so this is really what she's supposed to be practicing, is drawing out student ideas. And what do you think she could keep in mind for a second interview to do a little better? And just a quick tip, I know it's easy to focus on the content of what her interviewee is saying because that's also really interesting, but make sure here to focus on how Helen is or isn't drawing out her interviewee's ideas.
And so I just wanted you to maybe like describe what you see in the picture, what you think could be happening.
The electricity from like that the stove is getting is making like the little rings hot, and so like the heat is turning it red.
Okay. So you think it has to deal with like the like all that electricity being sent to like one of the coils, or like the one that's turned on?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so you're saying that all that electricity can make heat?
Yeah. Like it transfers from like electrical energy to like heat.
Okay. And so like how did you know that there would be a transfer there?
Because it was once electricity and then it's heat, and so like if there was some kind of change.
Okay. And like would you be able to like feel that or see it or
yes.
Hear it? Yeah.
I don't think you can hear heat.
Okay.
But you can definitely feel it and like see that, you know, it's obviously red and so it's turned on,
mm-hmm.
like probably as high as it can go.
Okay. So you think that like the color of the coils affects the setting it's on?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what do you think would happen if you put a pot of water onto one of the like red coils?
Well, first, like, the pot would start getting hot, and so, like, then the water would start getting hot, and then it would boil.
Mm-hmm. So, you'd say that, like, the water would also experience that heat?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And, like, could you give any more description of maybe, like, why that happens?
I mean, it gets hot, and so it just starts to boil.
Mm-hmm.
After I reflected on my first video, the mistakes that I learned from was that I was leading my interviewee too much, and that I would be asking questions in a certain way to lead her to an answer that I wanted to hear. And so a lot of the times when you help a student, they might not say exactly what you are planning for them to say, and that's okay. Just take the time to respond to how they're trying to think of something and what their mental model is and how you can help them through that. Since it was my first interview, I was so concerned with meeting my planned deadlines and my planned protocol, and I mean, things just don't go as planned. So when I started interviewing her, I was not really listening to what she was saying, but I was more focused on what I need to say next. But I should have been listening to what she was saying so that I could figure out what to say next. So I was too focused on my questions.